We have seen the binary fission. Now binary fissions are also the types according to the division of the organism. One type we'll study here is transverse binary fission. You could see in paramecium there was one word that is mitosis or amitosis. Amitosis means direct cell division. The whole organism divides itself directly. Okay, so that is directly the cell division. Here it is not like, you know, like your mitosis, that is first the nucleus will divide then other all things are divide. Here everything divides at one time, that is a mitosis, and taking place in protista or either some bacterias. Okay, you know protistas, those are bacterias only. So here we'll find paramecium, it divides by transverse binary fission. You could see transverse means, you know, this way horizontally the body divides. Body is, no, you'll see this part and it will divide. The cell, one cell will be divided here and the other cell down, and both the cells will live as an individual. Okay, so this is called as transverse binary fission. Amoeba you have seen, that is simple binary fission. This is transverse binary fission in paramecium. Okay, here there is a GIF of paramecium, that is binary fission, transverse binary fission, separation of two cells and each cell will live as an individual organism. The next fission is the longitudinal binary fission. Longitudinal binary fission means, now here is an example of euglena. Euglena divides longitudinally, that is, you know, this part, and two of those cells are separated out and leaves individual organism. You could understand this, suppose this is an euglena. It divides longitudinally. No, division is longitudinally, and two organisms are separated out this way. Okay, paramecium, transverse, amoeba, anyhow it divides because of its irregular shape. So we call it as simple binary fission, transverse binary fission, and longitudinal binary fission. One more type of fission we are going to study, that is in amoeba, that is multiple fission. Multiple fission, that is asexual reproduction, takes place. This type of reproduction takes place when there is not a suitable condition for that organism to reproduce. So amoeba stops giving out its pseudopodia. It has irregular shape, no? How the drop of water and then keeps on flowing as it gets the flow, but not like amoeba has an irregular shape, and it stops giving out its pseudopodia and becomes a round shaped spherical structure. Okay, and then it forms a hard covering. Its plasma membrane becomes very hard in structure. No, cyst. Cyst is formed around it, and inside the nucleus starts dividing mitotically into many cells. Okay, and these cells are kept in a cyst, no, very hard structure, like seeds are there, no, in some of the plants seeds are kept in the pods, like. So here also these cells of amoeba are kept in the seeds. You have seen the pods of beans, shengi we call, no, the pods are kept like that, and inside there are many cells of amoeba. This cyst gets, it breaks open when there is environment is suitable around. When the condition becomes favorable for the amoeba to grow, that time the cyst breaks open, and all these amoebas which are there inside, they will start moving out and live their life individually. Now what happens about this cyst? This cyst is not the amoeba. It gets degenerated. Okay, it doesn't live. It is only the cyst. It is only the bag to hold these cells. Now this bag is formed, or this cyst is formed, because of the old parent amoeba. isn't it? And inside, many daughter amoeba or daughter cells are formed, and they move away when they get a favorable condition. So this is called as multiple fission. Multiple fission takes place in amoeba or either in some of those organisms, but mostly in amoeba as well as in some protist. Here is another asexual reproduction, which is by yeast. No, yeast example of yeast we are going to take. It is the budding. No, budding takes place. Budding means a small outgrowth is formed on the yeast cell. Yeast cell is a fungus cell, isn't it? It is an unicellular fungus. An outgrowth is formed on the yeast cell, and as soon as the outgrowth is formed, you could see the bud here. The nucleus will start dividing and the other cell organelles will start dividing, and then they will be distributed in the bud. That bud, as it grows and becomes little mature, it will get detached from the parent body and live the life as a daughter cell.